Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with another Photoshop tutorial where we're going to be creating a very simple loading circle, which you can use on your websites or before your video projects. This effect, which you can see playing here, is going to take advantage of some of Photoshop CS6's improved animation capabilities, leaving you with a silky smooth result. Let's get to it. In terms of the size of the document, 1280 by 720 pixels should be large enough for most of the projects you're going to be working on, but feel free to use a larger or smaller document if you wish. As for the shape of the circle, there's a very handy custom shape that comes with Photoshop that's going to work great for a design like this. Go ahead and grab the custom shape tool from your tools bar, and then on your options bar at the top, open up the shape picker. By default, the shape that we're looking for may not be available, so you'll have to load in some additional shapes. Open up the Shape Picker's menu by clicking on the gear icon at the top right corner, and then choose the Shapes Pack towards the bottom. This will allow you to append them to the end of your current list, or replace them completely. And once they've been loaded in, scroll down a bit until you see the circle frame shape. This will give us that donut shape that we're looking for, which you can then drag out on your document as small or as large as you wish. The color of the shape doesn't matter at this point, as we're going to be adding a gradient overlay. And to do that, let's go ahead and hop into our layer styles with a simple double click on the new shape layer that we just created. Let's start with the gradient overlay, which is going to define the colors for our design. Now, before changing any colors, you're going to want to set the style to angle. This will allow us to create a gradient that will travel around the circle as we adjust the angle of the gradient. Now, once that's set, clicking on the gradient bar will bring up our gradient editor. We're going to be working with four stops, the two on each end and then two that we're going to create near the left side, which is going to help define the color of the glow. One is going to be placed around the 30% mark and then one around 40%. Clicking right underneath the bar will add a new stop. Now, the second stop from the left, the one placed around 30%, is going to be the color of the glow. I'm going to set that to a blue for this example, but feel free to use any color that you wish. The other three stops are going to be set to the same color. We're going to go with an almost pure black. Now, once you've set one of them, you can simply click on the others and then sample right from the gradient bar. Good, and that'll complete the gradient. Next, we're going to be adding an inner glow to add a bit of shine to the circle. Once the glow has been added, start by changing the color to a pure white, set the blend mode to overlay, and then the opacity to 100%. Now down below, go ahead and set the size to around 25 pixels, and then change the contour to ring. Of course, if you're looking for a different style of your glow, feel free to tweak the settings to your liking. And that'll complete it for the design, nice and simple and ready to animate. And to begin the animation process, we first need to reveal our timeline. This is usually found at the bottom of your workspace in a tab, but if it's not visible right away, you can activate it under the window menu at the top of your screen. Once it's visible, you'll likely need to press the Create Video Timeline button to begin animating. If your button currently says Create Frame Animation, click on the arrow to the right and choose the Timeline option. Now, once the timeline has been created, you're going to notice that the layers appear in the same order as they do in your Layers panel, and each of them can be expanded using the arrow to the left. You're going to want to expand the shape layer that we just worked on. Expanding the layer will reveal the different elements that can be animated. In this case, the position, opacity, style, and vector mask. Because we're dealing with layer styles, we're going to be animating the style element. Once you've identified what you're going to be animating, clicking on the stopwatch icon will create the first keyframe of the animation. At this point, we want to use the playhead at the top of the timeline to go to the next point in the animation. Now, you would think it would be a simple two-step animation, but it's actually not that simple, and I'll explain why in a moment. Now, when you're at the next point in the timeline, the gradient needs to be adjusted, so a simple double click on the gradient overlay layer style will open it up. Now, here's why it's not a simple two-step animation. For the angle value, there's no way to tell Photoshop to rotate 360 degrees clockwise. And if we set the angle at negative 90 degrees, Photoshop wouldn't know which way to go, clockwise or counterclockwise. So we need to give Photoshop a nudge. So instead of negative 90 degrees, we're going to be setting the angle at negative 89 degrees. This way, Photoshop knows to rotate the angle clockwise. Now, when you press OK, a new keyframe will be automatically added to the timeline. Now we can go to the next point by moving the playhead once again. This time, when we adjust the angle value, we want to set it to 92 degrees. Again, this will give Photoshop a nudge as to which direction the angle should rotate. And again, when you accept the changes, a new keyframe will automatically be added. Now before we play back the animation, you can also set the last frame of the animation by dragging the endpoint right to the current position of the playhead. Animating only one rotation is going to be enough, because if you wanted the animation to loop, under the timelines menu, you can choose to loop the animation if you wish. Now, pressing the spacebar will play back your animation. The first playback is going to be a little bit choppy as Photoshop is rendering each frame, but after that, the animation is going to be silky smooth. Now here's one more neat advantage of using Photoshop CS6. Layer styles can now be added to groups. So if I go ahead and place this shape layer into a group by holding down my shift key and clicking on the new group icon, I'm able to further stylize this design even after it's been animated. For example, I can go ahead and add a pattern overlay to give it a bit of texture. Photoshop comes with a bunch of nice textures, which may work well for a design like this. And of course, you can change the blend mode to blend it in nicely. Now again, after applying layer styles, the first animation is going to be a little bit choppy, but it's smooth sailing after that. And from here, you can export it as a movie file using the button at the bottom left corner of the timeline, or save it as an animated GIF if you choose. And that will do it, a simple animated loading circle in Photoshop CS6. As with all tutorials, take what you learned in this video and make it your own by changing the colors or adjusting the layer styles. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button down below, comment on what you'd like to see covered in a future video, and check out my other tutorials at ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com. Take care.